Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see the OxygenOS port for the POCO X2 or Redmi K30, whichever you have, which is OnePlus Nord port. So guys, let's begin. So as you guys can see here, this is the OxygenOS port. This is ported from OnePlus Nord. The Android version here is Android 11. The OxygenOS version is 11. The model here we get to see is AC2001. So yeah, and in this status these are the options available, the Android version. The kernel here we get to see is the Redcliffe kernel, so yeah, which is great. So yeah, this was the ROM specification. This is the OxygenOS. This is the settings. Let me just switch to the white mode. So here is the settings panel. This is the settings panel of the OxygenOS. Going to the home screen, this is the home screen. This is the OnePlus launcher as usual we get to see, and this is the, these are the quick settings of the OnePlus OxygenOS. So first of all we will be looking at the settings. This is just the whole OxygenOS and it's smooth and fluid. The 120Hz display is just working absolutely fine. Going to the display options here, these are the display options, the advanced, and here we get to see the resolution, and we also get to see the option QHD plus, but as you know, the display here is FHD plus. So yeah, this is a bug. This is what it happens when you switches to QHD plus. So just better stay at FHD plus. Then we get to see this option, the show front camera. We get to see the two punch holes. There is no notch style available in this ROM. So yeah, this is a bit irritating for me. And you can just hide it like this if you want to, so it will be just like that. Going back, the screen calibration option we get to see. We get to see the vision comfort, reading mode, dark mode and everything. Ambient display here is working perfectly fine. So these were the display. Then we get to see the customization option available here. This is the canvas option available. It works with the portraits only. Then the wallpaper, the clock on ambient display, you can select whatever you want. Then the fingerprint animation, it's of no use because we don't get to see the in-display fingerprint, the horizon line and everything. Then we get to see the theme, the default, and if you want you can set to cyberpunk also. Going back to sounds and vibration, here also everything is just the same. Then we get to see the volume panel, we get to see it on the left side. Going back we get to see the option gestures and buttons and gestures. You get to see the navigation gestures, and if you want you can set to the nav bar also. Then going back going to the security and lock screen here, the fingerprint scanner here is just working perfectly fine. As you can see, it's not that fast but it's working fine, so yeah, no issues with that. Face unlock here is also working absolutely fine. Then talking about the battery here, the battery backup on this ROM, I must say it's impressive, it's just great. The battery backup on this ROM here is absolutely amazing. This is the battery usage from 100% to 41%, and the screen on time is 3 hours 38 minutes, which is great for me. So yeah, the battery backup, there is no issue, it's just great. There are few bugs in this ROM present, we'll be talking about it later in the video, so watch the video till the end. Then moving forward to the utilities, we get to see the option quick launch, it's available. The app locker here is also available and is working fine. So yeah, then going to the system options, these are just the same options available. And to turn on OTG, we get to see the option from here, the OTG. So you can turn it on from here. Now moving to the home screen, this is the home screen, the OxygenOS clock channel. Swiping right, we get to see the Google feed, which is great. So, and this is talking about the quick settings, mobile data, Wi-Fi, hotspot, everything here is working fine. The 120Hz display here is working perfectly fine. The screen recorder here is available, so yeah, which is great. Then the Zen mode here is available, which is also working fine. So yes, and you can turn it on from here. So yeah, this was it. Talking about the camera here, the default camera we get to see is this is the OnePlus cam available, which is also working fine. As you can see, the photo mode, video mode, everything here in the OnePlus cam is working, and you can to see the 4K 30 and 1080p 60fps options available in this ROM. So Yeah, the video recording is just fine if you want to do. Then talking about the safety net status here, the safety net status, let's just check. It has failed. As you can see, the safety net status has failed in this ROM, and I have also rooted the phone and flashed the safety net CTS profile module, but still, as you can see, universal safety net fix. I had flashed it, but still the safety net hasn't passed. So yeah, the safety net status, the banking apps will just not run in this ROM. Then talking about the performance here, the performance has been just great, the gaming performance and everything. So the Geekbench scores are here, the 518 and 1610. So yeah, the scores are just average, and yeah, performance is just not an issue, everything is just working fine. We get to see the OnePlus dialer app and the messaging app. These are the OnePlus utilities options available, the OnePlus switch, the OnePlus file manager here is available. So yeah, the weather app and the notes, everything here is just available, and we get to see a lot of bloatwares here. The Google Play movies, the calendar one, Google One, which is of no use to me, the Google News, the Google Files, and you cannot uninstall all of these. So yeah, this is a kind of issue for me, and you also get to see the OnePlus Gallery app. So yeah, which is great. Now let's just talk about the bugs here. The bugs here is that the double tap to wake here is just not working. As you can see, double tap to wake is not working. So this is a bug present here, and there is also another bug. If you turn the display off, then it will just automatically turn on again, like so. Yeah, currently it's just working fine, but there is a bug that the display just won't get off. So yeah, this is an issue I had faced. After you double tap to turn off, the display will again turn it on automatically. So yeah, this is a bug present here. Otherwise everything here is just working fine. The ROM here has been pretty much smooth. Gaming performance is great. If you want, you can use it as a daily driver, but these banking apps are not running here, and there is no double tap to wake. It's not working. So now let's just talk about the installation process. The installation process here is very easy. Just power off your phone and reboot to recovery. Like, just follow these steps. You can flash this ROM like any other normal custom ROM. Now hold the volume up button and the power button and reboot the phone to recovery mode. So after you reboot the phone to recovery, just go to the wipe Dalvik cache, data and cache. After wiping this, just go to the files and locate the file wherever you have downloaded in the zipped file. Just select, I have just deleted it, just select the file and just flash it, and you are done. And after that, just go to the wipe and format data, type yes, and just click on this tick, and then reboot to system, and now your ROM will boot. So yeah, it's that much easy. Like, it's just like flashing another normal ROM. So yeah, it's very easy to flash the OnePlus OxygenOS ROM on the POCO X2. So guys, that is it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel, and if you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below or in the Telegram group. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and bye.